Hi there, welcome to another video from Hegarty Maths. It's Mr. Hegarty here, and in this video we're shading sets in Venn diagrams, our first video on that topic. So let's start with something we've previously done on Hegarty Maths. Please pause the video and draw these sets in a Venn diagram. So we did this previously, hopefully you would have got the following type of picture. Okay, so we're going to be using a Venn diagram and going to be shading particular regions or particular sets in that Venn diagram. In order to do that, I need to talk to you about some notation we need. So I'm going to use this very picture to describe that notation. So on a new page, here is that picture we already had. And let's talk about the notation we need. The first one, if you see A written, it means all the elements in A. So if you didn't know the sets here and you were just given the Venn diagram, you would shade everything inside the circle A, and clearly the elements in A are 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7, which you have here, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7, right? Now the next one you need, you'll see this A dashed. That means not A, right? That means, I'm going to write it here, not A. Or sometimes you would see it written as the complement of A. So it means all the elements that are not in A. So that is everything inside the rectangle that is outside our circle. Like that. So you would shade everything in the rectangle outside the circle. And you can clearly see that the elements here are going to be 1, 2, 8 and 9. Right? Next one, B. If you see B, that's easy. That's all the elements in B. You would just colour in this here. And all the elements in B are 2, 4, 6 and 8. Nice and easy. You knew that from here, 2, 4, 6 and 8. And similarly, B dashed or not B or the complement of B, that's clearly going to be all the elements outside the circle of B. So it's going to be everything inside the universal set that is outside B like that. So you would shade that in just to get a feel for what elements they are. And you can see that they are 1, 3, 5, 7 and 9. Okay, B dashed or not B or the complement of B is that. Right, now the last two are quite important. We've got to learn these. These might be new for us. If you see this, A, and the way we say union. That sign there stands for union. Or A or B, union or, that's how we say it. A or B, A union B. What it means is it means all the elements in A or in B or in both. So let me show you how you draw those. When you see a union, use the same colour. So let's draw in colour in A first. You colour in everything in A, like that. Okay? When you see union, you colour everything in B in the same colour. So you colour inside the circle in B like that. And A or B or A union B means everything in A or in B or in both. Now these elements here are just in A. These elements here are just in B. And these elements here, 4 and 6, are the ones that are in both A and B. And that is A union B. Now the last one we need to know is this one here, when you see this symbol. When you see this symbol here, this symbol means intersection or and. You'll hear it said as A and B or A intersection B. And what it means all the elements that are in A and B at the same time. So whenever I see this, whenever I see an intersection, I would colour in A, and I would colour in one colour. Let's say I colour in yellow. Now, when I see intersection, I colour the other set in a different colour. So let's colour B in blue, let's say. Like this. And the intersection is where the colours have merged, or where the colours have gone over each other. In this bit in here, in the overlap. It's always in the overlap. So A intersection B or A and B, they're the elements that are in A and B at the same time, namely in this case 4 and 6, and you need to know that. So let's get on and try some examples where we shade the regions here with the notation that we've just learned. Pause the video and have a go at shading the following regions in the Venn diagrams. Okay, nice and easy. The first one is A. All the elements in A, everything in the circle A, that's clearly everything in A. That there means A complement or not A, it's everything outside A. Everything inside the rectangle but outside the circle of A. So you would colour in the whole thing like that, and that would represent not A or A complement. So just to show you a neater version of that, here are the two answers you should have got. Right, let's do the next one. Pause the video and have a go at these. Now, what does this mean again? Remember, this means A or B or A union B. So the way you do unions, you color everything that you've got for the first set A in one color. Then you color everything inside B in the same color. And A union B is clearly everything that you've just colored. It's in A or B or both, like that. Now this here means the complement of A union B, or everything that's not in A union B. Now, given that you've already got A union B, and this is something you should just know, A union B, the complement of that, is everything outside that. So it's going to be everything outside those two circles, like that. Okay, and you'd shade all that in, and that would be your complement of A union B. And this is a nice, neater version of it. So hopefully you got that. Okay, next one. Pause the video and have a go. Now we're doing A intersection B, or A and B. Now the way I like to do these in future, just to help you get the shaded region, whenever you see intersection, color in the first set in one color. So let's color in A, let's say like this. Now when you see intersection, use a different color to color in B. So I'm going to color this in here like this. The region or the set we're looking for is A intersect B. That will always be the thing that is the blending of the two colors. The yellow and the blue blend to green. So this bit here must be the intersection that we're looking for. And I find that a nice neat way of finding that intersection or finding that region. But after a while, you should just know straight away that A intersect B is this bit in the middle. Now, not A intersect B. So you've got A intersect B and its complement. That must be everything outside this overlap here. So once you know A intersect B, the complement of A intersect B is easy. It's everything outside this region here. So you don't have to rework it out. It's just everything you've got inside the rectangle that is obviously outside that intersect. And if I was to neaten it up, it should look something like that. Okay. Next ones, pause the video and have a think about these. Okay, not A, union B. So let's, when we've got a union, let's use the same colours. Not A, let's shade in everything that's not A. Everything outside A. So I don't have to complete it. That's the basic idea. Now I've got union, so let's use the same colours. Let's now shade in B. So B's already a bit shaded, but I've got also shade in this bit here. See the extra bit I've got a shade in here? Like that. So not A union B is everything I have shaded there. Alright? What about A union not B? Well, let's start off by shading in A. So A is everything inside here. This circle here. Union means let's use the same colour, not B. Everything that's outside B. And there you go, you get the idea. And neatening it up, what would it look like? It would have looked like these two. Okay, last examples. Pause the video and have a go. Right, this time we've got intersect on the go, so let's use different colours. Let's firstly shade everything inside A. So there you go, let's shade everything inside A, like that. Now because we've got an intersect, let's use a different colour. Let's shade everything that's not in B. So let's everything outside B. Now what we're looking for here is the region we're interested in is going to be where the colours merge or the colours overlap. That's going to be this bit here. You see where it's gone green? This here is the region we're interested in, where A intersects with not B, and it's going to be that red portion there. Let's do the same over here. Let's firstly shade in not A. So not A is everything outside A. Because we've got intersect, let's use a different colour, not A, intersect B. So let's now colour in B in blue. And when we colour in B in blue like this, it's going to be everything inside the circle there. We find ourselves that the green colour, the merged colour, is where we're interested in here. So this is the region we're interested in that case there. So it's the red is what we would shade. this could be a bit of work, and we could rub out the rest if we want to rub out the rest so that we don't confuse someone. Okay, like that. And we could rub out the rest here and just leave ourselves with the red there. And if I was to neaten it up, it should look like that. And that's it for this particular video, our first video on shading sets in Venn diagrams.